And welcome back, our dear viewer. As we promised earlier, we are going to talk today about the conference which was held recently in Egypt, which is the Surveillance and Development Conference, which was held under the auspices of His Excellency the Prime Minister Sharif Ismail, and with the attendance of the Minister of Water Resources and Irrigation, Hussein Al-Mughazi. To shed more light on that topic and the development in that field of irrigation and the use of surveillance strategy in the development, we are very much delighted to have our dear guest, Dr. Haysam Mamdouh, the assistant head or the head of the Irrigation Engineering and Hydraulics Department, Alexandria University. Hello, sir, and thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, if you can tell us, first of all, the significance of this event that was held under the auspices of the Prime Minister.
Yes, that conference is 4 days conference. It is a regional conference under organized by the Arab Union of Surveyors with the Egyptian Authority of Surveying. Just what is survey, engineering survey? It is one of the basic civil engineering sciences, which has a lot of applications. The special focus of that conference on mega projects. So if you look for the agenda of that conference, there is about 7 sessions and 5 plenary sessions. All the topics we need it now in Egypt. It is just sharing the experience.
Yes.
Even so, we have 3 mega projects. We should discuss what is the lesson learned from the new Suez Canal project. In addition to that, the 2 mega other projects, the new capital in Cairo, in addition to that of 1 point.
Administrative capital.
Administrative, the planned administrative capital, and also the planned, the ongoing project of the 1.5 million acre of feddans. So the special focus will focus about how to implement the state of art in the field of engineering survey, in that, because we need to make a good rural and urban planning for our projects, how we plan the roads, how we make risk assessment, how we use the advanced technology like remote sensing and geographic information system. So this is a very good opportunity for the geodetic, the engineers, civil engineers or surveyors to gather their information in that.
Dr. Haysam, what about the participants of that conference? How they were chosen, on what basis, and what is the significance of the of their participation in that summit?
For any scientific conference, there is a call for that scientific conference in which any scientist want to participate, he should register to that conference. For that conference, there is about 300 participants, in which about 20 of them are from international sites outside the Arabic Union. So there is a keynote speaker has discussed the recent achievement. And an outstanding research topics has been discussed also in that field, mainly on the remote sensing and geographic information systems. And also there is a very good session about how we could update our educational syllabus in our university in the topic of survey engineering.
Yes. So did they come out with any recommendations in regards to the latest that you were discussing?
Yes, one of the main recommendations is how to incorporate databases, because we have quite a shortage in good database in Egypt. For example, in the 1.5 million feddans, we should make quite a good database for all the land of what we have. What is the soil type, the classification of soil type, in order to select the more economic crops to be cultivated. In addition to that, in the database include also the climate data like precipitation, evaporation, and also where is the best location about the land use around this area, and how those production of that unit will be transported in other Egyptian cities. So the database, one of the main points has been discussed, how we because in Egypt, in every ministry, we have some database, but we don't have a central database in which you could gather information about that.
Dr. Haysam, what are the major sectors in which the surveillance should be used?
Yes, for a simple purpose, so for our audience, if we want to make a new road or new city, in that case, we will make an excavation in which some part will be cut and some part will be filled. This is money, because if we cut 1 meter cube, it has a price, we want to fill. So what will be the optimal level or optimal location of that road in order to minimize the cost of the project? Without taking the efficiency of the project, we just want to minimize the cost, how to find the optimal cost. For example, in the 1.5 million acre, what is the optimal location of the wells? What is the optimal distance between wells? How we could incorporate all those technical knowledge so for the benefit of those two mega projects. So this is what two of the main objectives have been discussed. In addition to that, a special topic has been discussed is the risk assessment, because in some cases we could have some risk assessment in the economic feasibility, economy of any of those two projects, the administrative capital and also the 1.5 million acre.
Sir, to what extent do you believe that here in Egypt, in regards to the projects implemented, there is risk management? Or to what extent do you believe that they are concerned with risk management?
Simply, the word risk is determined by, from an economic point of view, is determined by the benefit over cost ratio. So in that project, in for any of the mega project, we have to minimize the cost and maximize the benefit.
Of course.
So we have a big risk in the cost of the implementation of the project, because those mega projects will cost billions, like that of Suez Canal. So instead of making, for example, the new project Suez Canal, 20 billion, it could be 18 or 20. So in the 1.5 million acre, the expected cost is around 40 billion Egyptian pound. How we could minimize this cost? Is it effective for us is to use modern irrigation system, sprinkler system, or drip irrigation? What is the location of the most promising area in order to minimize the cost? On the other hand, we want also to maximize the benefit.
Of course.
What crop should we be cultivated in those area in order to maximize the benefit? Those will be in conjunction use of the engineering survey science, in addition to what other other topics, like, for example, database and remote sensing technology, because if we want to make a leveling of that area, we will make a ground level, it will cost a lot of money, our budget. We need to apply the remote sensing technology because it is cost competitive comparing to other normal use.
Dr. Harrison, how can we make use of the science in making the surveillance and in creating a more proper environmental and proper atmosphere for the investors to come and invest in Egypt?
Yes, science, the most added value in our humanity is the science. For example, if you take a mobile, how much it could weight, how much it will cost, the added value of the science is could be used directly, not in only engineering survey, because this is a specified conference in one topic. In other topics, we need that, and what has been, we have allocated about 10% of our budget in education, in which 2% of them are for scientific research. So this could encourage, but the scientific research, the main drawback, it is a medium-term or long-term investment, not a short-term investment. But we have our scientific business in Egypt. We have more than 40 universities around Egypt, and with more than 130,000 scientists working in all fields in Egypt.
But how can you use this surveillance in the mega project, as you have kindly mentioned, in creating some sort of boom in the development process, and thus that could be reflected positively on other sectors in the economy, like investment, as I've mentioned?
Yes, in mega project we are talking, for example, we have what had been discussed is the two biggest mega project. For the 1.5 million acre, initially from 2 months it is just 1 million. It has been increased to 1.5 million. So what is the area have been selected? 12 areas have been selected around Egypt, and has been increased to 17 location around Egypt. So what is the optimal location of to select those area? This is the role of the engineering survey science, to select the optimal location in order to maximize the benefit and minimize the cost. In addition to that, survey science is quite have a history in Egypt. We have a lot of professors working in that field since then, two centuries ago, since the era of Muhammad Ali. We have quite a good experience in that. We coming to the new administrative Cairo, the location, because there is some concern about the location of that administrative Cairo. Is it better to make it 50 kilometers from Cairo or 60 kilometers, or make it quite far from that? It has been determined that this location could be a quite a good location with economic benefit for our economy, because it is not, it is, it will be near the Suez Canal in that direction. So what will be the rural and urban development and planning of that administrative? Will we allocate the residential area and industrial area, if there is some touristic area? Where is how to make the planning? This is the role of architecture engineer, not the role of engineering survey. And a lot of architecture has been attending this conference also.
So what are the challenges also facing us in this field that you're talking about?
We need a lot of facilities in Egypt. For example, for remote sensing, we don't have a satellite in Egypt here for making it. We bought the images from outside with a hefty cost. So in order to that, I encourage the government that we want to make one of these satellites for scientific purposes. We want. So this is one of the dreams of us as a scientist here in Egypt, to have our own satellites for scientific purposes. In addition to that, to make a lot of scientific
conferences. Is it costly, sir, to have?
It has been reduced dramatically during the last decade, and there is micro satellites now is more not more than 30 centimeters. But having a satellite is not expensive, but launching a satellite is very expensive. So we have that dream, and we hope that the Ministry of Scientific Research will allocate some budget in order to encourage Egyptian scientists to have those kind of information and make it available for all our scientists.
Yes. Do we use this surveillance strategy as well while digging the new Suez Canal project, Dr. Hayes?
For sure. One of the main fields of the engineering survey is how to estimate the cutting and fill and bill of quantities. And it has been used during the calculation of those 500 million meter cube of excavated soil. And also the route of the Suez Canal has been used. In addition to that, some technical problem one had been associated in dredging below the water level.
Yes.
And also it has been used in allocated the location of the tunnels, because now we are constructing about 7 tunnels from the western part to the to Sinai. So how to find the optimal location of those tunnels? We have it is now under construction, 3 tunnels inside Ismailia city. In addition to that, one siphon to pump water, to deliver water for making irrigation expansion inside Sinai.
Dr. Haysam, also as we are talking now about the Suez Canal, we are having other phases in that mega project.
Yes.
The development of the whole area of the New Suez Canal and, of course, the industrial zone. To what extent the surveillance strategy also would be used in that, and how this could help in creating a very successful project?
Suez Canal Regional Development Project has 7 components. In each component, the first step in any engineering project is to make a survey, to just to know what is the level of the lands that we have, what is the difference of level, how we will allocate and making the planning. And it has been already used in those 7 components, the port in the north side and the south side, and as you have mentioned, the industrial zone in Ismailia, and also to that extent, there is a new residential area in the eastern part in Sinai. All this has been implemented, and this has been discussed in that conference during the scientific discussion about the lesson learned from this canal mega project, which is undergoing, and it will take not less than 5 or 10 years until the big figure will be clear for all of us. I hope that.
Of course.
So, sir, in regards to this field, are we up to date and we're acquainted with the latest technologies, or we are a little bit behind?
I think Egypt is one of the top countries in that field. In that direction, we have a lot of students, PhD students, working outside and during a mission supported the Ministry of Higher Education. But we have a lack of facilities in Egypt. For example, if we want to make a scientific research we need to allocate some budget in that direction, in that of engineering survey. Mm. Our drawbacks is that we have a shortage in the budget of scientific research in Egypt, mm-hmm. in that field especially, yes. Mm-hmm. So I hope that this be considered by the Ministry of Education, Higher Education, mm-hmm. in conjunction with the Ministry of Water Resources and with His Excellency, Mr. Prime Minister, Engineer Chief Ismail, who is this conference is under his auspices. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Dr. Haysom, as we are celebrating the 42nd anniversary of the October War victory, we can now talk about the development of science and how the surveillance strategy could be used in establishing and helping in creating mega projects in different places of Sinai, since, of course, it's an important agenda for the current government to have real development in Sinai.
Before that, as you have mentioned about October, the military survey we have an inside mm-hmm. our has played a very important role during the October War. Mm. So this is maybe could be outside of the sky. But now Sinai is a huge area with more than 66,000 kilometers and it contains a lot of resources and very good opportunity for investment even in north or south or in the middle Sinai. So just to allocate, we have make an initial feasibility study planning of the urban planning of Sinai since 1989. But this plan should be updated and implemented, because what have been done in Sinai, in South Sinai we have implemented a lot of touristic places, but in the middle of Sinai we should improve our strategy in order to increase the investment. There is an industrial zone, very small industrial zone inside El Hasana, and also in North Sinai, what it has been declared recently is that we will expand a lot of fish farms in North Sinai, and how to allocate those fish farms in order to improve our economy.
Yes, indeed. Yes. What else about the development of Sinai, Dr. Haysom, as we are heading for a new era of the development of the whole country? So do you believe that other projects should be, or particular projects regarding that field of irrigation, maybe in order to have real development in this part of the country, which has been neglected for years?
Yes, a lot of projects has been declared recently. One of them is the Golden Triangle in Red Sea. It has been declared since President Sisi came to become president 1 year ago.
Yeah. But now, can you tell us more, sir, about it?
It is a golden triangle. It will be just to some minerals that, but we have a lack of information, and we should improve our knowledge. And this is about the database that we have mentioned. We don't have a clear database about that. Mm-hmm. But we have also a very big challenges in our current mega project.
Yes.
The cost of the 1.5 million feddan is unbelievable. We dig a wells for 1,000 meters, which could turn this project uneconomic if we will not make a good scientific research using the engineering survey. Because we don't have enough water resources, and this project will rely mainly on groundwater, which is not renewable in Egypt. So a lot of topics should be discussed between scientists in those three or two mega projects.
Of course. Dr. Haysom, also we would like to shed light, which is a very different topic, of course, about the development concerning the River Nile, and of course the agreement signed or the meetings which was signed between Egypt and Sudan and Ethiopia recently concerning the Nile. So of course it's a very important topic to Egypt and for our security, the national security. So how do you read this?
After 8 rounds of negotiation as a declaration of principles in March, during those 2 days there is also an expected meeting between Egypt, Sudan and Ethiopia, and we want to, because there is a very big technical problem that the two consultant firm, one of them has been withdrawn from the negotiation, and there is some expectations that it is Deltares from Netherlands will return back to take 30% of the task of evaluating the impact of Great Ethiopian Renaissance Dam on both countries downstream Egypt. So I expect that maybe by tomorrow or the day after tomorrow we could know what is the current situation. We have a lot of scenario. Should we rely mainly on the French consultant firm PRL, or if Deltares will be involved, or we should find another consultant firm to make the hydraulic modeling of that issue. But it has more than 1 year of discussion, and this is the situation of that, because every country wants their benefits. And
they want to prolong the process so that they can then
unfortunately, this is the case, Karim. We are prolonging the negotiations and some the choice of the firms. Now one firm is pulling out, so
On the other hand, the building is ongoing.
That's more than 60%.
Yes.
But the Egyptian Pope has visited Ethiopia last week, and also President Sisi has met Hela Mariam Desalegn, the Ethiopian Prime Minister, and the goodwill of Ethiopia is clear that they will not have, that them will not have a negative impact on Egypt.
Hopefully.
Hopefully, yes, for sure.
Speaking about surveying, can we foresee the effects of this using this technology, the top of the line technology, to know the exact effects or the expected effects on the Egypt's share, the water share from the Nile River?
For sure, we have our prediction system in which we have a daily images of that reservoir if they have start filling or not. Till today, they didn't start filling in that reservoir. So the size of reservoir could be estimated by the implementation of remote sensing technology, which is 74 billion meter cube. And what other news, that Sudan has constructed a new dam and they start filling that reservoir. We could know using the remote sensing technology what is the situation in the upper basin.
And speaking about this reservoir, sir, is it also going to affect our share?
It could have some if you build any dam, it could have some negative impact and also positive impact. The negative impact, because this water, if it will be used in irrigation, it will impact your share. But if it will prevent the flooding inside Sudan area, so it could increase your share. So any building, any dam could have negative, and
it's a double-sided
like that. Make it for Aswan High Dam. Is Aswan High Dam had negative impact or positive impact? Have both. It have increased our share, our uses of water, and also this is positive impact. It had reduced the fertility of our land.
Yeah, the soil.
The soil.
That was my common question, Dr. Haysan, about the, not only we are facing maybe a problem because of the construction of the dam and our share of the Nile water and how that could affect Egypt, which is already suffering from water scarcity, but also the soil, to what extent the soil of Egypt could be affected furthermore by the construction of the Renaissance Dam as well.
About our soil, it will not be, it has been, the soil quality has been reduced dramatically after the construction of Aswan Dam.
Yes, yes.
And this has been forced us to make...
Thank you very much, Dr. Haysan. But now we have to go live for the military celebration for the 42nd anniversary of the October War victory. Dr. Haysan Mamdouah, the head of the Irrigation Department, Alexandria University, thank you very much for being with us. We go live now.